TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Surabhi Sharma. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 2nd of December. Protesters demand justice for Wet's murder, rape in southern India. Pakistan government reaches out allies to amend Army Act. And 13th South Asian Games begin in Nepal with grandeur. And now for all the details. At least 17 persons lost their lives due to a wall collapse triggered by heavy rains in India's southern Tamil Nadu province on Monday. The weather department has predicted more showers over the next 2 days and advised fishermen not to venture into the sea.
A wall collapse triggered by heavy rains in Coimbatore district of India's southern Tamil Nadu province killed at least 17 people on Monday. The incident took place early in the day after a compound wall collapsed, damaging 3 houses in Metupalayam area of the district. Rescue officials rushed to the spot to retrieve bodies of those killed and rescued many trapped survivors. The provincial government has announced ex gratia of around $5,500 to the next of the kin of the deceased. Meanwhile, heavy rainfall caused waterlogging in several areas in provincial capital Chennai, disrupting normal life. In the wake of incessant rainfall across Tamil Nadu, schools and colleges across the province were declared shut on Monday.
This is an ever-ending story for us for every year. And especially in November and December. So you can see my home, how much it is affected, mainly due to the high rainfalls.
The weather department has predicted more showers over the next 2 days. An official said there may be very strong winds as well, and fishermen have been advised not to venture into the sea.
The gang rape of a veterinary doctor whose body was set on fire and dumped on the outskirts in southern India has sent shockwaves through the country. Angry protesters across India on Monday took to the streets to condemn the incident and called for a surgical strike on rapists. Angry protesters in India's southern Hyderabad city took to the streets to condemn the rape and brutal murder of a 27-year-old woman last week and crimes against women. Carrying flags and placards, the protesters raised slogans as they demanded the accused to be hanged. The charred body of the veterinarian was found on the outskirts of the southern city of Hyderabad on Wednesday night. The victim was allegedly gang-raped by 4 men and was later killed and her body was set ablaze. The police a day after arrested 4 accused persons involved in the case. Meanwhile, massive outrage was also seen in Indian capital New Delhi as people took to the streets to protest against the government. Protesters called for a surgical strike on rapists and questioned the government's silence on the matter, demanding swift trial in the case and justice to the victim. The incident is reminiscent of the fatal gang rape of a young woman labelled Nirbhaya by Indian media on board a bus in 2012.
हमारे सर्जिकल स्ट्राइक रेपिस्ट के ऊपर कब होंगे करते हैं रेप करके भाग जाते हैं पूरा जुडिशियली सिस्टम चलता रहता है चार चार पांच पांच साल हो जाते हैं किसी को कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता जैसे लोग निर्भया के दरिंदों का वेट कर रहे हैं फांसी का वैसे ही लोग वेट कर रहे हैं कि कैसे होगा ये सब इसका समाधान क्या है
मीनवाइल एंग्री इंटरवेंशंस वर विटनेस्ड इन बोथ हाउसेस ऑफ द इंडियन पार्लियामेंट Lawmakers expressed anguish over the incident and made a case for setting up more fast-track courts to deal with cases of sexual assault. King Carl XVI, Gustav and Queen Sylvia of Sweden arrived on a 5-day visit to India on Monday. The king and the queen met Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi in capital New Delhi and held talks aimed at broadening the spectrum of bilateral cooperation.
King Carl XVI, Gustav and Queen Sylvia of Sweden arrived on a five-day India visit on Monday in capital New Delhi. This is King Gustav's third visit to India and the king is leading a high-level business delegation from his country. Indian President Ramnath Kovind and the First Lady greeted their majesties during the warm ceremonial reception at the Presidential Palace in their honour.
There will be a number of different seminars and also I know that there is a big Swedish delegation from the business community. I think we are nearly 100 people from Sweden and they are looking forward to have their discussions, the opposite number here in your country and also in Delhi, but they also move around in the country. So we are looking forward to discuss common interests and like industry, like development, in energy, environment questions, and even I hope, which is my subject, discussing about forestry.
Upon arrival, Indian Foreign Minister S. J. Shankar met King Gustav and Queen Sylvia of Sweden and reaffirmed India's commitment to deepening and expanding India-Sweden cooperation across sectors. The King and the Queen later met Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi and held delegation-level talks. During the talks, the leaders affirmed the common desire of building greater convergences on bilateral, regional and global matters of mutual interest. The ties between India and Sweden have been on an upward trajectory in the last few years and bilateral trade volume was $3.37 billion in 2018.
In news from Pakistan, the ruling Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf party has started contacting its allies as the government looks to amend the Army Act to ensure Army Chief General Qamar Javed Bajwa's extension beyond 6 months.
The ruling Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf or PTI has started contacting its allies as the government looks to amend the Army Act to ensure Army Chief General Qamar Javed Bajwa's extension beyond 6 months. A meeting was held by Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi with a delegation of the Mutahida Qaumi Movement Pakistan or MQMP in this regard on Sunday in Karachi. MQMP leader Khalid Maqbool Siddiqui, after the meeting, expressed unconditional support to the PTI government, local media reports said. This comes as Pakistan's Supreme Court on November 28 granted a temporary 6-month extension to General Bajwa's tenure, but said the government must pass legislation through Parliament in that time to clarify the section of Pakistan's constitution governing the armed forces. During Bajwa's tenure, the military has been accused by opposition politicians of electoral manipulation to help Prime Minister Imran Khan win power last year. The military has denied interfering in politics.
Moving on, university students in Gilgit-Baltistan recently held a sit-in protest over the abolishment of fee compensation policy, which they cannot afford. They blamed they were promised free education before their admissions, but they are now being pressurized to pay for it.
Students of Karakoram International University in illegally occupied Gilgit-Baltistan recently staged a protest against abolishment of fee compensation policy. The protesting students held placards against the new rule under which they won't be getting refund of their fees as promised earlier. They also chanted slogans against the university authorities and the Pakistani government. Demonstrators said that according to a government scheme in 2011, the students were promised free-of-cost education in any university across Pakistan, but now they are being pressurized to pay for their courses.
तो जब हम एडमिशन ले रहे थे तो उस वक्त हमें यह कहा गया है कि यह फीस आप जो एडमिशन फीस दे रहे हैं आपको रिफंडेबल है आपकी कोई फीस नहीं है आप फ्री पढ़ सकते हो तब हमने एडमिशन लिया एडमिशन लेके तकरीबन हमारे पास 700 के करीब स्टूडेंट हैं हमने सर्वे किया हुआ है कि 700 से कोई 90% स्टूडेंट ऐसे कि जो फीस पे नहीं कर सकते गिलगित-बल्तिस्तान आपको पता है कि एक माशी लिहाज से बहुत कमजोर इलाका है तो اس لیے ہم یہاں پہ بیٹھے ہوئے ہیں
کہ 2011 اسکیم کے مطابق ہماری کوئی فی نہیں لیا جائے گا. ایڈمیشن لینے کے بعد ہمیں پتہ چلا کہ یہ لوگ ہم سے فی لے رہے ہیں جو کہ ہم ان کو فی نہیں دے سکتے. یہ ہمارے لیے بہت بڑا مسئلہ کھڑا ہوا, ہم لوگ نہیں دے سکتے فی.
University students have held several demonstrations in past few months to highlight their plight, but the authorities have turned a deaf ear to them. Locals in Gilgit-Baltistan, which Pakistan occupied more than 70 years ago, claim such policies by Islamabad are part of a conspiracy to keep the region backward.
Nepal on Sunday formally inaugurated the 13th edition of the South Asian Games in capital Kathmandu with grandeur and fanfare. Around 3,000 athletes from the 7 SAARC countries will compete during the 10-day multi-sport event.
The 13th edition of the South Asian Games was inaugurated in Nepal on Sunday with grandeur and fanfare. The multi-sports event was declared open at the newly constructed Dasada Drangasala Stadium in capital Kathmandu in the presence of about 30,000 people. The inaugural ceremony kicked off with a march past by athletes from the SAARC countries, which include India, Nepal, Pakistan, Bhutan, Afghanistan, Maldives and Sri Lanka. The South Asian Games torch was brought to the stadium after it was toured in all the 7 countries. During the 10-day event, around 3,000 athletes from the 7 SAARC countries will compete in 26 different sport disciplines in different venues across Nepal, including Kathmandu, Pokhara and Janakpur. The athletes will be competing for 324 gold and another 324 silver medals.
Wait for a giraffe was finally over for a zoo in India's northeastern Assam province this weekend. A female giraffe from eastern Patna city graced the Assam State Zoo on Saturday after a period of 8 years.
A zoo in northeastern Assam province finally welcomed a giraffe in its premises after 8 years. As part of an exchange program, 2-year-old female giraffe was on Saturday brought to Assam Zoo cum Botanical Garden in Guwahati city from eastern Patna city. The ruminant will soon be joined by its male counterpart, which is being brought to the zoo from southern Mysuru city and will reach within 1 week, said an official.
Giraffe بہت سمے سے جو ویٹ کر رہے تھے وہ ابھی اسام زو میں آیا ہے. اٹس پٹنہ سے آیا ہے, فیمیل جراف ہے, لیس دین ٹو ایئرس. اس کا پارٹنر میل جراف ابھی میسور سے آلریڈی روانہ ہوا ہے, سو اندر وت ان ون ویک وہ بھی ایکسپیکٹیڈ ہے اسام زو میں آ جائے گا. سو آفٹر اراؤنڈ ایٹ ایئر کے بعد ہمارا جراف یہاں پہ آیا ہے, تو سب لوگ وی آر آل ویری ہیپی.
In 2011, a female giraffe named Lakshmi, which was one of the major attractions for visitors, died of age-related ailments. Since then, the giraffe shed in the zoo lied empty. Giraffes are the tallest terrestrial animals found on Earth. They attract large number of spectators to zoological parks.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. Protesters demand justice for Wet's murder, rape in southern India. Pakistan government reaches out allies to amend Army Act. And 13th South Asian Games begin in Nepal with grandeur. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.